My name is Dan Paluh, and I'm a Ph.D. candidate at the Florida Museum of Natural History, and I study the evolution and anatomy of reptiles and amphibians using CT scanning to understand how shapes and sizes evolve across frogs and lizards.
Hi, I'm Maggie Hantak, and I'm a postdoctoral researcher in the Florida Museum of Natural History. A postdoc position is kind of like what you do after graduate school. It's a temporary sort of research position. And what I do for my research is that I study the ecology and evolution of color pattern variation in salamanders.
So what are amphibians and reptiles? Amphibians include three groups of animals, which are the frogs, salamanders, and the little known Sicilians. And reptiles include lizards and snakes, turtles, and crocodilians like the alligators behind me. It also includes the little known tuatara, which are only found in New Zealand today. I use natural history collections to study the anatomy of reptiles and amphibians. And one way I do this is using CT scanning, which is generating X-ray images of museum specimens. And so I use these data to study tooth variation across species. So looking at how the number and shape of teeth change, looking across different species of frogs and salamanders.
So natural history collections are integral in understanding how species change over space and time. So if we think about anthropogenic influences like urbanization or climate change, we can use natural history collections to see how these species change with these impacts. So for instance, I study a salamander species that varies in color morph, so it just has two different color patterns. And I can study with museum collections how these salamanders have changed from the 1950s to today in the frequency of those two morphs over different areas that have urbanization and that are changing in climate at different rates. So why should you care about reptiles and amphibians? Reptiles and amphibians are really important for both ecosystem balance and ecosystem health. So for ecosystem balance, amphibians and reptiles eat a lot of pests. For example, frogs can eat things like mosquitoes, and snakes will eat things like mice or other pests. And also, they serve as food sources for other animals as well. So it's really important in keeping that balance. And then for ecosystem health, amphibians can be an indicator of poor quality habitats, especially in aquatic areas. For instance, frogs and salamanders have really permeable skin. And so if they're able to take in toxins that are in environment, you're gonna know because they're not gonna be in that particular place.
If you wanna find reptiles and amphibians, I recommend having very good observational skills because they can be very hard to see to the untrained eye. And it's also important to go to places and go to those places at certain times that increase your odds of seeing them. So the Chua Trail is a great place to see reptiles and amphibians, and depending on what you want to see, you should go at certain times. So if you want to find frogs, it's best to come to the Chua in the mornings or evenings during or after rain. And if you want to find alligators, snakes, and turtles, it would be best to come during the day when it's warm and sunny. Amphibians and reptiles are very sensitive creatures, so it's best to observe them from a distance and never to disturb or touch them. And it's also important to watch where you step because there are alligators and venomous snakes that can be found in these parks. But as long as you don't interfere and disturb them, they're very unlikely to harm you.
So how can you help amphibians and reptiles? There's a few things you can do just in your yard alone. You can build small natural ponds in your yard. You can not use herbicides and pesticides. You can leave leaves in your yard for places for amphibians and reptiles to hide in. And you can also leave your cat indoors because they are predators and they may prey on amphibians and reptiles.
The Chua Trail and other Florida state parks are critical for the survival of amphibians and reptiles because they provide vital habitat from swamps to streams to longleaf pine savannas, that are the kinds of habitats that many species can only survive in. And so there are over 100 species of reptiles and amphibians that can be found in Florida state parks and little other places in the state.
You can leave leaf litter in your yard for things to hide in.
Should have kept going, that would have been great.
Yeah, gesundheit. That is actually great. Yeah, if they do that, keep on going.
Well, that startled me. Yeah.